hello and welcome back. That was a shock, all of us then. Robin and Maurice Gibber with us this morning. Only two-thirds of the Bee Gees. Where is the other Bee Gee?
He's in Miami.
Why is he not here?
Because he's frightened stiff of flying the Gulf War, did he, you know?
Oh, that's a poor show.
It is a poor show.
A lot of people did it, actually. You know, they were all a bit scared to fly during the war, but now the war's over. I mean, everyone's feeling a lot better, of course.
So you think you would be able to tempt him across?
I think so. If they keep up the security, I think it's a much better way of flying. Mm. I love that, I must admit.
Is he not a particularly good flyer anyway? He doesn't particularly like it?
Not really. I think Robin was the worst at first. But
I started out really bad at flying and got better as time went by. He got worse.
Right. Yeah. But do you have the sort of lifestyle where you're jetting off all over the place, or do you tend to stay in the one place?
We do fly a lot, and I think that's why over a period of time you just can't get frightened all the time, otherwise you make yourself a wreck.
When you do travel, are you sort of whisked through VIP lounges and things like that? And do you have to queue up with the hoi polloi, or can you...
Well, if you live in one place at one time, you get to know the customs people and the passport people, so that helps.
Who you know, yes. You are who you hug.
We can do it, it's no problem.
No, I mean, we're nice to them and they've been nice to us, so when we come through, they're quite, you know...
But they keep changing so much, keep getting to know new people. It's good to know people at Heathrow.
Yeah. But where are you based now? Where do you live now? Where do you consider your home?
Well, we're 50% England, 50% America. Yeah. You know, we try to be over here as much as we can. But when we're making an album, for instance, then you're in the studio for a long time, so we're naturally in Miami Beach a bit longer.
Right.
Like this year, we missed summer over here because we were recording the new album. So. Mm.
Do you have to work? Or do you do it because you want to do it?
Well, it's like somebody winning the Pulitzer Prize for journalism and then quitting. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, why would they quit? Or... You know, a scientist winning the Nobel Peace Prize. Why would he stop being a scientist because he's won the Nobel Peace Prize? You know, it's like
we just do what we do because we love doing it. We just love writing, producing, creating, and all those other wonderful things.
It's also our hobby. You know, so it's,
of course, it's great. That's brilliant. That must be great to be doing something that you really enjoy.
Yeah,
it's great.
It is wonderful. It's lovely, isn't it? It's lovely. It's nice.
So listen, you have to stay there because we have to go to the weather now.
Okay.
But we'll be talking to you lots more after half past eight.
All right, okay.
And hearing your music.
Yes.
Good.
Let's get the weather for Maurice.
You're with us this morning. Good morning to you both again.
Good morning.
See if I could just take you back.
<Good morning.
laughs> If I could just take you back in time a wee bit to the days of Saturday Night Fever. Mm-hmm. It's only really recently that John Travolta, that made him a huge star, but that John Travolta actually managed to sort of shed that image, you know, with Three Men. And what was the film again? Look Who's Talking, that's right.
Well, that was originally called Daddy's Home. And in fact, I didn't even know Staying Alive was in the picture until I went to see it, because it changed the title on it.
That's right.
And it was quite funny seeing him walking down the street pushing the trolley
with
the baby and
funny.
Then Staying Alive going.
It has taken him a while to sort of get over that. Was it the same for you?
We had a similar problem, of course. There was a bit of a backlash after...
I think the difference with John is that, of course, he was very much part of the film.
Yeah.
And he was in the film, and it's for an actor, of course, it typecasted him a lot. Mm. It's more like Superman did for Christopher Reeves. So he had a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, we could sort of chip away at the stone with our music, but he had to wait for the right director to say, yes, I'll take a chance with John Travolta in a film that isn't...
But it was so successful, and I think you even had like a period of a couple of years where you sort of backed off a little bit.
We did, and wrote for other people. We did Chain Reaction for Diana Ross.
We started off with Barbara Streisand. We got off the Barbara Streisand to do, and that's what started it, and we thought we'd lay low but still have our songs out there with other artists.
Yeah. Right.
After that, it was Dionne Warwick and Kenny Rogers and Dolly Parton, Islands in the Stream.
Islands in the Stream.
And, Chain Reaction for Diana Ross, which before that we decided to work on ourselves after Diana Ross from then on.
Right.
And we did with You Win Again and stuff like that.
Well, shall we have a bit of nostalgia now?
Would you like?
Yeah, come on, let's have a bit of nostalgia. We shall talk about the things you're doing at the moment, but right now, let's have How Deep Is Your Love, Alex.
I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain. And the moment that you wander far from me, I wanna feel you in my arms again. And you come to me on a summer breeze, keep me warm in your love. Then you softly leave, and it's me you need to share. How deep is your love? Is your love? How deep is your love? I really need it. Everybody shake it, 'cause we're staying alive, staying alive.
nostalgia, nostalgia. You made a really interesting point there, that you made videos for all of your songs before video really was around. I mean, that was the late 70s.
Well, English artists did in the 70s. All through the 70s and the late 60s, English artists did more videos than American artists.
I mean, even the Beatles did one with Strawberry Fields. I mean,
that's true. But
everybody has just had the format of video and the outlet like satellite or MTV or all that sort of
didn't
stuff.
Exist.
Didn't exist in those days. So.
But now it's really, you have to have a video now.
Well, we've got everybody quite a collection makes, ourselves.
Everybody
yeah.
makes videos.
Yeah, it's part and parcel. If you make a record, you make a video.
Yeah. Well, what about the new album that you're working on right now? Is that all completed? Have you got that?
All done. It comes out in about 3 weeks' time, 2 weeks' time. High Civilization, it's called.
Is it very different? Is it radically different from what you've been doing?
It keeps the R&B roots that we've always pursued, and it's more up than the last album we had out.
It's more high energy. And it's us of the 90s, because we keep going forward as much as we can.
Because it's 1991, isn't it?
Exactly.
It's just 1991.
Well, it's better than saying that of the 80s.
You know, you were saying that you write songs for all these different people, all these really famous people. Have you ever wondered, you know, or thought, I don't really like the way they've done that song, or you would have done the song differently, or do you usually think...
Yeah, I mean, for instance, Islands in the Streams for Kenny Rogers and Dolly Parton, we would have done more sort of Motown soul R&B, where they did it more country. You know,
Well, that was because of the image of Kenny and Dolly, really. Yeah. But when we're in charge of the production, then we have full control. So we know how, Dionne Warwick's Heartbreaker was recorded fast at first, and it wasn't the way we wrote it. We wrote it much slower, and when we slowed it down to its original tempo, it worked. But, you know, if you're in charge, it's fine. But like with Jimmy Somerville, With To Love Somebody, that was a great version of a song that we wrote in 67. So the substance of the song lasted into the 90s.
You boys raspled. You were your life.
That's right.
That was great, because none of us had any idea. And apparently,
what were you actually doing? What did you think you were doing?
Well, we thought they were filming A Day in the Life of Steve Wright at Radio 1, so... we went along to do the interview, and we had to get dressed, of course, because we were filming him, you know. So we thought, well, great, well, you know, Steve's a pal, you know, we'll all go in and have a chat. And we got there, and we had no idea. And I thought when he came in, I thought he was doing This Is Your Life on Steve Wright. Because I thought, who's this man with all the makeup?
Because when you're in a normal setting like that, and you see somebody come in all dressed up for television with makeup on, it's almost like a cardboard cutout, you see. And you turn around, and you do a double take. It's Mike Hassel, Red Book, and you think it's very sort of contrived that he was this image of This Is Your Life. So you take it for granted, it is This Is Your Life, but you don't ever think it's for you.
And on that, just before the show started, were you all three saying, oh, I hope they don't talk about it, I hope I don't hear from that. I hope the tax man's not behind that.
Yeah.
And that's the Uncle Eric from Albania.
It was the unknown Gibb.
It was just really nice. I mean, people like Frankie Howard and the lovely thoughts from Michael Jackson and Barbara and Dion and all those people.
But it's not the finish.
Oh, no.
I mean, This Is Your Life. I mean, it wasn't mortal.
Oh, yes. I mean, obviously, so far.
This Is Your Life so far.
Yeah, well, there was a lot of things that, because it's such a short show, that they couldn't use, but we were told that it could have been a two-hour special because of the people who wanted to do it, which was very nice.
Lots of tissues, tears.
Lots of tissues and lots of stories and relatives.
And lots of champagne. More chat later.
Okay.
Brilliant. We'll take a break.
Bryce Gibb in the kitchen, about to eat a wonderful meat recipe. The only trouble is, one of the boys is a complete vegetarian.
Utterly.
Good morning. Welcome back.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be back. I've missed you all very much, and I'm really happy to be back. And the Gibbs brothers are here, which I found out the last time were twins, remember?
Absolutely. It's an easy mistake. what tasty morsels do you have on here?
The tasty morsel is I'm making a Mexican meal, but it's using Dutch bacon.
I'll give you a good run of your money.
It's put me off a little bit because Robin's a vegetarian. That's really put me off now. You eat meat, though.
Oh, well, you know, cut off its head and wipe. Well, hang on. No, listen, now, what you're cooking here, I mean, you don't necessarily, has everybody got to sample it?
Well, I've made you one. You see, you know, you had This Is Your Life the other day. This was going to be your sucker.
We were serious after we eat that. It looks lovely. It really does.
It is lovely. It's really easy meal. You can eat the lettuce
avocado. There's something moving in there. No, it really is very nice.
Oh, dear. I'll tell you what it is. It's really a lovely recipe and very easy. Nice snack for the weekend. And what it is, I've in there is the onions and garlic. I didn't want to...
Is that what it is?
Yeah, can you...
No.
Okay. And into that, I've put bacon, which I've cut the bacon into four... into eight.
Do you like this, Rob?
Yeah, I'm fascinated.
Oh, dear. Nice. Just cut it. And what I've done is just put the pieces in gently like that.
Yes.
And it's cooking.
And it's there, it's away. Right.
Then after that, I'm putting some spice into it, which is paprika.
And this is a weekend dish.
This is just a quick snack.
This is a weekend dish.
And this spice is called cumin. That's what it is.
Sorry?
Well, that will last you the whole weekend.
It's gone. Cumin. It's, if you can, you can smell it more than everything.
Hell.
It's an Indian spice.
Right.
And it's, well, you can smell it, can't you?
Yeah. Oh, you can certainly smell it, though. It's all over the studio.
Well, everyone wants some, don't you?
Yeah!
Oh, lovely!
You poor sod. All right.
And then into that we put one tasty...
$1 of something.
$1 of tomato puree.
Tomato puree, of course, a natural.
That mixes in. It's a really nice, easy recipe, actually.
It is. It's easy, it's light, it's airy.
Where are you going on your
I don't know.
Tomatoes in and beans are in.
Yeah, pour the
beans in. I'm making a
half. Is anybody seriously going to eat this this time of the morning?
Except you. Everybody.
I mean, I don't care if you're vegetarian or not. This time of the day,
Oh, yes. But it's a nice, quick recipe. This is it.
Like Blazing Saddles.
Yes. It is a little bit. I mean, this is going to stay for a while.
This is very nice.
Really going to hang around for a bit.
So there you have that. And what it is, you then put some avocado in it. Yeah. You can save some back to decorate with.
Oh.
So, if you're going to decorate.
Are you putting something else in it?
Something else goes in there as well.
Good grief.
Oh, yes. It's easy. Can I just go through the recipe again? Because it is that quick. Yeah. All it is, you need some oil, olive oil.
Of course.
Well, who cooks for you when you're traveling? Olive oil.
Anybody
you can grab. olive oil, your onion and your garlic.
Of course, of course, love.
That bar's all right. Then you put your bacon in.
You're all right, love.
Yes.
You're okay.
We're all right for time. Yeah. We're all right. We've got time. Right. And then you let that simmer.
Let it simmer.
For 15 minutes. Got,
and what's this?
That's it. Finished.
Goodness. It really looks like it's finished as well.
It's a little...
Well done.
You then put
in
the taco shells which you buy, and then you warm it up for 2 minutes.
Dead, in fact.
It's because it's a bit dry. All you have to do
Very
is pack
dry.
It in
and
decorate accordingly. You can have cream and things on it.
And you can use it as bookends if you want.
And you're going to give us the recipe?
I shall give you the recipe.
Thank you very much.
And saddles.
If you don't put any bacon in it, could Robin eat it?
Yes, he could eat it. If we took the bacon out, he could eat it. Yes.
Well, you've got to coax him a little.
It would take a lot of money.
let's have the recipe. Let's have the recipe. You will need 2 tablespoons of olive oil, 2 medium onions, 1 clove of garlic, 8 rashers of smoked bacon, 1 teaspoon of...
Robin and Morris.
Exclusive interview.